Hello students, welcome back to Tejas classes. I hope you are all doing very well. In today's session, we are going to start a new series on ancient history, the most important and demanded topic for all the competitive examinations. Today, we are going to learn about the Paleolithic age, the first stage of prehistoric period. Prehistoric period is the period before the ancient history starts, where we don't have any written evidence. That is, there is no any written evidence, and the only evidence for tracing back the prehistoric period is the archaeology evidence. We'll look into about it in detail in the upcoming slides. So before starting our session, please join our WhatsApp group and Telegram channel, where you can find the daily quizzes on different topics as well as the free PDF materials exclusively prepared by the experts. Now, before learning about the Paleolithic age, first we need to understand what we are learning about. We'll look into the broad classification of Indian industry, and then we'll look into the Paleolithic age. First of all, Indian history. Indian history is a very broad subject, and it is classified or divided into three parts. So the first one is the ancient history, the second one is the medieval history, and third one is the modern history. So these are divided according to the time periods. Here I have given the time periods. So ancient history is between 2 million BC to 1200 AD. That is, we have seen the evidence, that is a evidence of an ancient man 2 million years ago only, and it continued up to 1200 AD. And coming to the medieval history, 1200 AD to 1857 AD, and modern history 1857 to 1947 AD. In this year, we have got a independence. And further, we classification of ancient history into six parts. The first one is prehistory and Harappan civilization. That is, we are going to see the prehistory now and the Harappa civilization in the upcoming video, and the remaining topics so on. Now, this prehistory and Harappan civilization has spanned between 2 million BC to 1500 BC. And after prehistory and Harappan civilization is there, that is Indus Valley civilization, is the first civilization in the world. So after this, we comes to the Vedic age. And after Vedic age, Mahajanapadas, this period is also known as Buddha period. Mahajanapada's period is also known as Buddha period, as Buddha was born in this period only. And after that, we'll be going into the Mauryan and later Mauryan. In this later Mauryan, who is a famous king? King Ashoka. So we learn about the Ashoka and various dynasties. And after that comes the Gupta and the post-Gupta period, which is between 240 AD to 600 AD. So this is a broad classification of Indian industry. So, classified as ancient, medieval and modern. And in ancient history, so this is the ancient history series, we'll be concentrating only on this topic. And in this video, we'll be concentrating on the prehistory. So, let us see the further classification of prehistory. Yeah, prehistoric period. As I already mentioned, this is a period where we don't have written evidences. The only source of this tracing back this history is archaeology evidences. Archaeology evidences or excavations. So we have archaeology survey of India and the people who excavate for different things, right? So this is a authority which is responsible for these evacuations and tracing back a history. So prehistoric period is again further classified into three ages. The first one is Stone Age, the second one is Bronze Age, and the third one is the Metal Age. Okay, so Stone Age means in this age, people know, that is the humans know only about the stone, and they lived with the help of the stone only. So stone played a major role in this age. And after this age, there comes the Bronze Age. So after Stone Age, they have invented the bronze metal, and the period continued from 4000 BC to 1500 BC. And after this comes the Metal Age, where they invented the iron. So 1500 BC to 200 BC. Generally, this classification is based upon the tools the ancient man which he has used. So according to the, that is based on the tools used, we have classified this prehistoric period, and we'll look into detail in the about the Stone Age now, and after that we'll go into Bronze and Metal Age now. Sorry, let me clear off this. Yeah, see, the Stone Age is further classified into three ages. One is a Paleolithic Age, Mesolithic Age, Neolithic Age. So, Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic. First of all, let us understand what is lithic means. Lithic means, this is a Greek word which means stone. Okay, this means stone. So, Paleo means old, which means it is known as Old Stone Age. Paleolithic, Old Stone Age. This is the early stage of, that is the early traces of where you actual the evidences of human beings, that is the ancient man, has been detected. Now, the what is the time period? From 2 million BC to 10,000 BC. And after Paleolithic period comes the Mesolithic period. Meso means, again, one second. Meso means middle. So, middle or late. Now, so Mesolithic means middle or late stone age. And after Mesolithic comes the Neolithic age. Neo means new, that is a new stone age. So, we have divided the prehistoric period into three phases initially, that is Stone Age, Bronze Age, Metal Age. And Stone Age is further classified into Paleolithic Age, Mesolithic Age and Neolithic Age. Now, I guess you have got a broad understanding about the Indian history. See, let us go back here. Yeah, so Indian history, ancient, medieval, modern. We are looking now ancient series. And in ancient series, we are further classified into prehistory, Harappa civilization, Vedic Age, Mahajanapadas, Mauryan and late Mauryans, Gupta and post-Gupta. And again, in the prehistory, we have divided into Stone Age, Bronze Age and Metal Age. And the Stone Age again classified as Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic. Guys, please take a screenshot of this classification, or you just prepare a complete classification chart. I'll try to provide the complete classification chart in the Telegram or WhatsApp group. Please download it. This chart will help you a lot in remembering the different ancient history periods. It's very important. By learning, you don't remember exactly. So through these mind maps and the pictorial representations only, maximum remembrance is possible. Now, yeah. See, after this, I have told you, in the Stone Age, we have three classifications. And in the Bronze Age, we have come the Chalcolithic Age. Chalcolithic Age is nothing but, in these three ages, man used only stone. Okay? So, what are the later developments in the usage of stones, we will be seeing in these three ages. And after this, what man has done, this ancient man, he used stone plus copper. He has found the copper metal and... But he don't know what actually it is, but he has found something. So it is the copper, and he has mixed the stone and copper where you used to make tools and different materials. So this period is known as Chalcolithic Age, where copper plus stone is used. And after this comes the Metal Age. As I've already said, in this Metal Age, iron has been detected, and it has continued from 1500 BC to 200 BC. So this is a broad classification. Please take a screenshot of it. I'll give you 2 seconds time. Please take a screenshot of it. Yeah. Now we'll see the Stone Age classification. See, I've already told you the Old Age or a Paleolithic Age in India is divided into three phases according to the nature of stone tools used by the people. And also according to the nature of the change of the climate. So, these are classified majorly on two things. What are they? Types of stones used. Types of stone tools. Okay. Types of stone tools used, as well as the climate change. So, these are the major things. That is the factors which are based on which this classification is done. Now we'll see this. See, we have seen history, and as well as after history, we have come to ancient history, and after ancient history, we have come to prehistoric period, and after prehistoric period, we have classified into Stone Age. Okay, now Stone Age is further classified into these three. See, you can see this period 2 million BC to 10,000 BC. Very, very long period, guys. This is a very long period. So for better understanding, we've classified this period into three parts. Don't worry this about this classification. You might think that there's a lot of classification in, we are going in depth. Nothing is there in, guys. Very easy. Once you you see the complete video, you get the clear understanding. And when you revise, you may get the information in a half page or maximum only one page. You need to learn only a one page regarding the prehistoric period. That's it. So basic understanding is necessary. That's why you need to watch this video at least once. Now, see this Paleolithic age, it is old stone age, as again classified into lower, middle and upper. So the lower age, the period is up to 1 million BC. We call this period as old lower Paleolithic age. And from 1 million BC to 40,000 BC, we call this as middle. And from 40,000 BC to 10,000 BC, we call this as upper Paleolithic age. And after Paleolithic age, we come the Mesolithic age. And after Mesolithic, we come to the Neolithic age. Now, we'll see the basic topic of this today's session, that is Paleolithic period. Now, this Paleolithic period is developed in the Pleistocene period. Pleistocene period is what, nothing but the period in which Earth was covered with full of ice. So you can see the picture of the Earth. So it is covered with full of ice. And the glaciers were started melting from this period. But at that time, at this point, it is, was full of ice and the human living was very difficult. But when the glaciers melt, right? So at the time of period, when the glaciers melt, so there was a place where this living of human was possible. So there, these humans used to live. And Paleolithic men did not know the use of fire and they did not practice any form of agriculture. Okay, Paleolithic man, the first ancient man, he was not, you don't know actually the use of usage of fire. So only in the later Paleolithic and Mesolithic they have invented the fire, and after that they have started this agriculture. But in this Paleolithic period, they did not know the usage of fire and any form of agriculture. Basically, they were hunters and gatherers. They were hunters and gatherers, means they used to hunt the animals, or they went into search of food for any fruits or any berries like that. Okay, and Paleolithic men belong to the Negrito race. What? Paleolithic men belong to the Negrito race. Negrito race is nothing but the people which we see in nowadays at present period, the Andaman people we see, right? So those people are classified as Negrito race. So initially ancient men used to they will actually belong to these Andaman people race, that is known as Negrito race. And now it is interesting to know that the first discovery of rock paintings was made in India in 1867 to 68 by an archaeologist, Archibald Kareli. Okay, so the first rock paintings, ancient, we all know that ancient man and the history is famous for its rock paintings and the rock tools. Now, so when it was discovered initially in 1867 to 68, discovered by a famous archaeologist, Archibald Kareli. Here you can see the prehistoric, that is a Paleolithic period, where there is full of ice. Now let us see the evolution. This is the picture regarding the evolution of man, that is how human evolved from the apes. Not, guys, human has not evolved from the apes. They used to be ancestor species. I'll teach you in detail about in the evolution of man. But remember, man has not developed from the apes. So there is another creature who is the ancestor for the humans. So in the lower Paleolithic period, human was like this. Okay, so the human was like this. He was totally bent and he used to walk, and maximum used to walk in two hands with two legs. And in the coming period, that is from lower Paleolithic to middle Paleolithic age, he has transformed a little bit and he has become somewhat straight. So see, here you can see the picture of him, the second one. Here he has become somewhat straight. So this posture, actually this is known as Homo erectus. Erectus means straight. So he has become Homo erectus in the lower Paleolithic age. And after that, by passing on to the next period, that is Middle Paleolithic, Upper Paleolithic age, finally in the Upper Paleolithic age, the human has attained the form which we are now. So this is the person which we are now exactly. He has attained this shape in the Upper Paleolithic period. So the posture of man is known as Homo sapiens. So at this time, the developed man is known as Homo sapiens, and the first modern man appeared in this Upper Paleolithic age. In lower Paleolithic age, between lower man and middle, he has become Homo erectus, and by subsequent periods he has become the complete man in Upper Paleolithic age. Now let us learn about the lower Paleolithic age. We have seen the Paleolithic age, then now we are seeing the classifications. Now it covers the greater part of the Ice Age. See, I have already seen what is the Ice Age, Pleistocene period. Pleistocene period is nothing but the earth was covered with full of ice. So there was no chance for a flora and fauna and environment development. So it was full of ice and gradually developed into the normal thing. Now, hunters and food gatherers. They used to hunt and they used to gather for the food. Tools were used were hand axes, choppers, and cleavers. Very important, guys. You may get a question from this, like what are the tools used in the lower Paleolithic period, or this particular tool belongs to which period. So I have given a picture for your references. This is a chopper. Okay, they used to chop the things, and these are the hand axes made of tools, and these are the cleavers. See here, these are the tools which were made by the ancient man in the lower Paleolithic period. They know only the hunting and gathering. They used to kill the animals with this, and they used to peel off the skin with this cleaver, and they used to heat the things with the help of these tools only. Earliest lowest Paleolithic stone is Bori in Maharashtra. So the first excavation which was done for finding out lower Paleolithic period is in Bori in Maharashtra. Very important, guys. The first Paleolithic site is Bori in Maharashtra, where we have found the traces and archaeological evidences of this Paleolithic period. And limestone and pebbles were used to make tools. So there was no metal discovered at that time. They used this limestone. See, you can see this. This is a limestone and pebbles. And what are the major sites of lower Paleolithic age? That is, in this age where man used to live in India. So we have this Son Valley. In present, it is present in Pakistan. So near the Son Valley, they used to live. And in Thar Desert, very famous Kashmir, and Mewar Plains, Saurashtra, that is Maharashtra nowadays, and Gujarat, Central India, Deccan Plateau, Chota Nagpur Plateau, north of Kaveri River, Belen Valley is very important, guys, where you can find the people living from all the ages, starting from Paleolithic age, Mesolithic age, Neolithic age. So people lived in this place in all the ages. They continued their habitat over this place. An important place is the Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh, very UNESCO World Heritage Site, Bhimbetka in Madhya Pradesh is very important, where you can find the rock shelters. See, the ancient man doesn't know how to build the houses also. He was not aware of fire, he was not aware of agriculture, he was not aware of clothing. So he just went in search of food, that is, he hunt for food and he ate, that's it. And he used to take shelter under these rocks. These are rock shelters. Very important, guys. Now, after lower Paleolithic age, we have come to the middle Paleolithic age. As I have already said to you, these ages are classified based on the type of stone tools used. So initially they used the hand axes something in the Paleolithic age, and after this they tried to develop these stones, and they tried to changed the design of these stones, which led to the Middle Paleolithic age. See, tools used were flakes, blades, pointers, scrapers and borers. Okay, in Lower Paleolithic age, the tools were nearly blunt. Okay, they were uneven shape, they were blunt, they were not very sharp. While coming to the Middle Paleolithic age, they have become very sharp. Here you can see they have become very sharp, and the tools were flakes, blades, pointers, scrapers and borers. These are the tools, very important, you need to remember this. I'll give you a mind map for this, don't worry guys. You just don't try to remember in this video, you just see the video, you just go by the video. After that you'll get a clear understanding. Then if you read the one page material, that is enough. Now, the tools were smaller, lighter and thinner, obviously. So initially they use the large stones, and after that they might have got an idea and to a period. So after that they started to make the things very small, lighter, thinner. And after this, what are the important Middle Age Paleolithic age sites? So in this age where man used to live, so in this period the climate slowly, that is gradually, started to become warmer. It has not become warmer, but from the ice age it has slowly gradually converting into the warmer phase. So this has made these people to shift from one place to another. Initially there were only some places where climate was suitable for those people. Now climate is becoming more suitable in different places, so they started moving. And the new places are, see, Belen Valley in UP, very very important guys, and Luni Valley, Rajasthan, Son and Narmada rivers, Bhimbetaka, Tungabhadra river valleys, Patwar Plateau, Sangao Cave near Peshawar, Pakistan. So this is a very important site guys, where ancient man used to live. Now comes the Upper Paleolithic age. So I think I need not explain you about this, because if you have seen the ages on based on the development of stone tool, here you can see the stone, see how sharp and accurate they have become. They have made polishing very well, they have made the pointers, okay, they have made small things. Okay, so this is the development of tools. Now coincided with the last phase of the ice age, when the climate becomes comparatively warmer and less humid. So in this period the climate become totally warmer and it has become less humid. It was very suitable for the people, that is the ancient man, and also for the flora and fauna development. Now emergence of Homo sapiens. As I have already said you, emergence of Homo sapiens. In the early Paleolithic age, we have these Homo erectus. See here. This is the Lower Paleolithic age, and before that man used to be like this. He was very short, and gradually he has developed into these phases. And after Homo erectus, in the final phase of Upper Paleolithic age, he has become Homo sapiens. Here you can see the image of the human, which is same as of we now. See, innovation in tools and technology. Obviously, you can see the differences in the tools which are made in the Lower and the Upper Paleolithic age. They have become much smarter, that is the ancient man has become smarter, and he has started developing the different types of tools. And also bone tools are nothing but after the killing the animals, they used to make the tools with the help of the dead animal. After eating that, they used to collect the bone, they used to make the tools out of it. So very very innovative. Yeah, from initially used to make only stones, and after that now he has come to bones, see, including needles, harpoons, parallel sided blades, nothing but two side sharpening, fishing tools. See, he has also started this fishing also. Now initially he used to hunt only animals, now he got an idea for eating the fish which is in water, and burin tools also. This is about the Upper Paleolithic age. Now what are the major sites of Upper Paleolithic age? Again the same things: Bhimbetaka, south of Bhopal. Hand axes and clevers, blades, scrappers and few burins have been found here. So I have already said you guys, there was no written evidence in this period. We'll be only knowing about it through the tools and either ruins or dead bodies of the ancient man. So these stone tools have been found in this Bhimbetka place and also as well as the rock shelters. And Belan Valley, Son Valley, Chota Nagpur Plateau, Maharashtra, Orissa and the Eastern Ghats in the Andhra Pradesh. So in this period they have moved to the South India. That is Andhra Pradesh. Here you can have given a picture for you. See, here is the Belan. Very important thing. Here is the Belan and here is the Son Valley, where the maximum, the people majorly lived in these two areas in the all the phases, lower, middle and upper Paleolithic age. And bone tools have been found only at the cave sites of Karnool and Munchalta Chintamani Gavi in Andhra Pradesh. Very, very, very important. Very, very important. So these bone tools, where they were found after excavations in Karnool in Andhra Pradesh. There was a place in Karnool and Munchatal Chintamani Gavi in the Andhra Pradesh where they have found this bone tools. Yeah, you can see the bone tools. Let me see. Yeah, these are the bone tools. See, these are the bone tools. Okay, so we have covered the sites of Upper Paleolithic Age. Okay, now we have completed the complete Paleolithic Age. Now we'll briefly see what we have learned in this session. First one is in Lower Paleolithic Age, Middle Paleolithic Age, Upper Paleolithic Age. So what was the climate at that time in the Lower? It was mostly the Ice Age, mostly the Ice Age. And this is also the Ice Age. It has been converting slowly, but it used to be Ice Age only and not that much warmer. And in the Upper Paleolithic Age only, the climate got comparatively warmer, where movement of humans was possible due to this climate change. And in the lower paleolithic age, these humans were Homo erectus. Here you can see somewhat the spinal cord used to be in the S shape. Generally we say that in the S shape, and it was not straight but a little bit straight. And after that, in the middle age, Homo neanderthalensis. So he used to be like this. And in the Upper Paleolithic Age, the modern man has been evolved. He is known as Homo sapiens. Now also we are called as Homo sapiens. And what are the tools they were used? Hand axes, choppers and cleavers. And in Middle Age, flakes, blades, pointers, scrappers, borers. And in the Upper Paleolithic Age, see, bone tools were come. Bone tools including needles, harpoons, parallel-sided blades, fishing tools and burying tools. Very, very important. This, see, the entire session which we have covered now, which we have learned now, is in this one table. This, that's it guys. Once you need to go through video only once, and after that you need to study with the help of these mind charts, classification charts and the tables. So please take a screenshot of it. I'll wait for 2 seconds. Please take a screenshot of it immediately. Yeah, that's it guys. That's it all for today's session. I hope you have enjoyed the video and got the information required. And we'll be covering the next Mesolithic and Neolithic period in the next videos. Daily I'll be posting the videos, and required material will be posted in the Telegram and WhatsApp group. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe our channel. And thank you. Have a good day.